S, video, or composite, which should you use in video capture? Some VCRs have an S video output, and some don't. For those that don't, you have to use what's called a composite cable, sometimes called an RCA cable, or sometimes that yellow cable. The problem with composite cables, though, is that they cause artifacts. And what do I mean by artifacts? Well, I don't mean this, although that is what pops in my head too. I mean this, the analog to digital artifact. If you look at the zoomed in box on the top right, you see some beads in a line. That's called dot crawl. That's one of the artifacts that is caused by a composite cable. Here's another example. Look at the line between the yellow and the blue, or between any of the colors, and you'll see examples of dot crawl. So composite cables cause artifacts, like dot crawl and something else called rainbowing. Now, the big rule in video capture is to use hardware that prevents artifacts in the first place. But if you can't prevent it, then try to fix the artifacts by using either a hardware filter or a software filter. So how do you prevent the artifacts I mentioned above? Well, you can use an S video cable. And if you're not able to do that, then you can try to fix it by using a comb filter. For a long time, I would read the discussion forums and I would read about comb filters, and I had no idea what that was. Every time I thought about a comb filter, I had this picture in my head. So I will explain it to you in a way that I think makes sense, but first I have to take a step back. In the golden age of television, there was just black and white sets, and the information that was sent over through wires contained what's called luma information. Later, when color televisions became a thing, they used the same wire to send chroma information. Chroma is the color information, and luma is the black and white information. Sometimes you see this referred to as Y and C. Anyways, the chroma and the luma were put onto one wire and in one channel. And they did some tricks to try to keep the chroma and the luma separate, but they sometimes smushed together, and that created some artifacts. Now, this wasn't such a big deal on color televisions because they were pretty forgiving. But when you do analog to digital capture, it can create a problem. So to avoid this problem in the first place, what you need to do is send the chroma and the luma on two separate channels, on two separate wires. And that's exactly what an S video cable does. S video actually stands for separate video cable. It actually doesn't stand for super video. It stands for separate video. And that's what it does. It has a separate wire inside for luma and a separate one for chroma. So if an S video cable can solve the problem, but you don't have an S video port on the back of your VCR, what are you supposed to do? Now, if you look again at that composite cable and that one wire in there, it actually has two separate signals and they're sort of coexisting on different frequencies, but they touch and sometimes they overlap, and that's what creates the artifact. This is where a comb filter comes in. Now, comb filters can either be hardware-based or software-based. For the hardware-based comb filters, you might sometimes see them referred to as a YC comb filter, a Luma Chroma comb filter, a 2D comb filter, a 3D comb filter. And there's a difference in particular between the 2D and the 3D ones. I sort of was confused about this for a long time. I didn't quite understand what they meant by that. It's just a better way to do the filtering because it looks not just at the information that's in one, I'll call it frame of video, but it looks at a couple of frames ahead and it tries to make intelligent decisions about how to remove some of these artifacts. Whereas 2D comb filters don't look at the frames ahead. They only look at what is in the frame in front of them. Anyway, you have different options for a hardware-based comb filter. And the one that I have that I want to talk about is the Panasonic ES15. Because what I really want to test is what does video look like when it's output directly through S-video? And what does it look like when it's output through composite, but then a comb filter is applied to it before it continues on its way through S-Video to a capture card. So you see in the first test, I'm going to start with a Hi8 camcorder to do this test. And in the second test, I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to use a VCR. All right, so let's do the first test here. This is a Hi8 camcorder with composite out to the ATI-9600. Look at those two bottles on the bottom left. You see there's like a band, a horizontal band there. And I see some rainbowing and I see some movement in those two bands. That will go away in a moment when we put the ES-15 into the workflow. So now the ES-15's comb filter is doing its job. The rainbowing is mostly gone. When I pause the video, I see a little bit of rainbowing, but it's mostly gone. And it looks a little bit sharper than without this comb filter in the workflow. The only problem is the ES-15 clips the whites a little bit. And so in that sense, it removes some detail. When you look at the Hi8 going directly out S-video to the ATI, you have all the benefits of that comb filter, but none of the drawbacks of the ES-15. So the whites aren't clipped as much, and the jumpiness is gone. There's no rainbowing. So this is why you would want to use an S-video cable. By the way, this is what it looks like when I output this footage directly from the Hi8 camcorder to the ATI capture device. This was not saved onto a tape. This was recorded live right into the ATI capture card. And you can see there's stuff that happens when you record onto a tape. And when you don't use a tape, you don't have that jumpiness there. These are my settings that I used for the camcorder. On my Panasonic ES-15, I turned off the line-in noise reduction. You access that by pressing the display button. And I set the black level control to lighter, darker, which is the best practice according to the experts. Okay, so for the test results, I think that it's clear that the composite output is not as sharp as the S-video output. The composite output had some rainbow effect. When the composite output was combined with the comb filter, it sharpened the video, but because of the sort of problem with the ES-15, it clipped some of the whites and we lost some of the detail. So that's the trade-off that you have to make if you use the ES-15. But I wanted to see, is there a way to prevent the clipping of the whites in the ES-15 by adjusting the brightness and the contrast in Virtual Dub? So what I did is I went into Virtual Dub and I changed the processor amp settings at 164.86. The detail is getting lost in the ball underneath the lampshade and also in the little jars. So this was too bright. I tried a different setting of 158.102, but you can see this blows it out even more. I've now actually lost more of the detail. So this is not good at all, although it does make the picture in the background on the wall, it makes those details come through a little bit more. So you have to sort of play with these brightness and contrast settings to try to find something that is acceptable. Here we are at 158.82. So this is better, but it's still probably too bright. And you can see in the ball underneath the lampshade is that you can't see all those dots as you can on the one on the left. And here we are at 154.58. So this is 10 less brightness than on the left and 10 less contrast than on the left. And this is, I determined, as good as it's going to get. We're not going to be able to see any more of those dots in the ball under the lampshade. By the way, this is with the lighter, darker settings in the ES-15. I decided to try play around with the ES-15 settings to see if that would make a difference. So here is darker, lighter. Instead of lighter, darker, this is darker, lighter. And you can see it plays with the contrast and the brightness, but it doesn't do anything that I wasn't able to get by playing around with the settings in Virtual Dub. And finally, I tried out lighter, just to see if that would have any impact, but it really doesn't. Okay, so to answer the question, can I prevent the clipping of whites when using the Panasonic ES-15 by adjusting Virtual Dub? Nope. It won't help. I decided to see if I could do anything in Adobe Premiere, playing around with the exposure and the contrast here, but it wasn't able to do anything more. I could never retrieve what is now lost information in all those dots in the ball underneath the lampshade. So I decided to do another test using a color bar. This is what a color bar looks like from a PNG file that I got from Wikipedia. This is a perfect graphic file. But I was able to make a color bar coming out of my DVK-200. My DVK-200 from Data Video is a chroma keyer. It's also used as a weak TBC. Anyways, this is what it looks like when you send it out from S-Video right into the capture card. By the way, if you have one of these and if you want to do this, you have to set the dip switch to 6. You have to push the 6 down in order to activate this color bar. So this is what it looks like direct. And now in the next test, we are going to send the color bar to a high 8 tape, and we're going to play that high 8 tape back into the ATI. So obviously this looks much worse, but this is what it looks like when you've sent it to a tape. In particular, look at the space between the colors. You can see there's overlap. This is giving you a real sense of the, you know, weakness of that high 8 system, you know, compared to more modern technologies. This is what it looks like when the camcorder is sending out a composite version, or the version through a composite cable, to the ATI. It looks softer. It actually looks a little bit better because it's not as sharp and you don't see all that sort of noise. It's not as bad as in the other version. But this is giving you a good sense of the difference between composite and S-Video when you output to a capture card. So here we are. This is composite also being output from the camcorder, but now we have the ES-15 in the workflow. So the ES-15 with the comb filter is trying to fix some of the weaknesses of composite. It does look pretty close in terms of sharpness. It looks pretty close to the one we saw earlier with S-Video out from the camcorder. But, you know, maybe this isn't the best test for this because the color bar is, they all look pretty awful, actually, when you look at them like this. So test results for the color bar. I think the composite color bar looks softer than the S-Video color bar. And with the ES-15 pass-through, it looks sharper, but also noisier, sort of like the S-Video version. But as I said, maybe this wasn't the best test. Okay, so for the third and final test, we're going to do something different. In the previous test, the high 8 tape is able to capture 440 lines of horizontal resolution. That's what we saw in the first test. But now I want to do it with a VHS tape, which only has 240 lines of horizontal resolution. I want to test that, the comb filter versus the S-Video cable using a regular VHS tape. So what you see on the left is composite out from a VHS player. You have S-Video out from a VHS player in the middle. And you have the ES-15's comb filter doing its thing on the right. So I think it's clear that the S-Video gives you the clearest, sharpest image if you look at the horizontal band on those bottles. But in this case, the ES-15's comb filter doesn't do as much as in the previous example. It's not bringing back the level of sharpness that that we saw before. So I'm tempted to say that when you have a VHS tape, which has a lower resolution than a high 8 tape, I don't know that the comb filter is going to improve the sharpness to the degree that we saw before. And of course, the ES-15 has its problem where it makes things too bright. And basically, you can't see any of the dots, almost any of the dots in that ball underneath the lampshade on the video on the right side. So I think it's another good reason why you should, if you can, stick with an S-Video cable. An S-Video cable will avoid the problems that we saw. Okay, let's sum up this video. What have we learned here? Well, we learned that composite output can cause artifacts like dot crawl and rainbowing. We learned that it's best to use a VCR that has S-Video output. But if you don't have one of those, then you can add a device with a hardware comb filter in the workflow, and that will get you close to what you would get through S-Video. We also learned that 3D comb filters are better than 2D comb filters. And finally, remember that software comb filters in something like hybrid, those are an option too. I didn't talk about them in this video, but maybe I will in a future one. Hey, if you've stuck to the end, thanks so much. You can click like, you can leave a comment. Those all help other people like us with this crazy hobby to find this video.